On Thursday, Minnesota Governor Tim Walz announced the state will join an initiative started by President Biden to slow COVID-19 cases. Any Minnesotan who gets their first COVID-19 shot beginning today through August 15th will receive a $100 reward. It's an effort to get infections under control with the Delta variant of COVID racing through the country. Well, here to tell us what we should know about the new variant is Dr. Rajesh Prabhu, infectious disease doctor with Essentia Health. And doctor, thank you so much for coming in and sharing some of your insights with us tonight. Are you seeing a lot more cases of COVID-19 starting to come through the hospital?
I don't think it's picked up tremendously as of yet. I think these rises of cases are in pockets of country that you see that people aren't, the lower vaccination rates are those people that haven't had COVID before. So this area has, you know, a decent vaccination level.
Doctor, how does the Delta variant differ from the other variants?
Well, I think it's more contagious and it's more transmissible to other people. So meaning if you have a Delta variant COVID, your chances of it transmitting to other people are more than the previous versions of Delta. And that's why you're seeing cases rise throughout the country.
Mm-hmm. And are you seeing Delta show up in this area when people get their COVID-19 results back? Does it tell what kind of a variant it is in the positive?
I think you can say most of the country, the majority, well over probably 90% are all Delta. And that's the issue, is that every version of variant that come through the United States, one got the top dog and someone come to replace it. So Delta is the new coronavirus that's circulating.
The CDC is recommending that people go back to wearing masks, probably pretty much across the board, all age groups. What kind of response do you think the country is giving in return for that request?
I mean, I think it's a very reasonable request, and this is the reason. First, it's more contagious. And people that are even vaccinated can get COVID-19. But the good news is that the vaccine prevents serious versions of COVID, meaning so sick that you land in the hospital. So you may catch COVID, but your chances of having a very poor outcome are very minimal.
Mm-hmm. Doctor, are there any legitimate concerns in your mind in terms of why people are hesitating to get the vaccine?
You know, I haven't heard personally from patients regarding that. I think it's more needing understanding of how serious COVID-19 can be. So in the United States, through and in this region, went through a period where we had a significant portion of our hospital full with just COVID patients. We even dedicated wards to COVID. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I've met patients in the hospital that have gotten COVID and didn't realize how serious it could be. Mm-hmm. So now that we have a vaccine that's very effective, it could really prevent those chances of getting a severe case of COVID.
So should vaccinated people still be concerned about getting COVID?
Oh, certainly. I mean, especially with the Delta variant. I mean, it's been shown that you can still get COVID even if vaccinated. But the point being is, the odds are you would not get a severe case, meaning it's 93 to 100% effective from preventing you from being hospitalized with COVID if you do catch it.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Is it frustrating to you, doctor, as a medical professional, to see how COVID-19 and vaccines have really kind of gotten wrapped up in politics in the country, and people are taking stands not necessarily based on science, but based on political views?
Yeah, I don't quite understand why it's so politicized. I talk to my own patients, you get sort of present the evidence of why we think, you know, a certain thing is beneficial, COVID vaccines. And usually they come to the similar conclusion what the medical professional is suggesting.
Doctor, what's the concern with children? At what age maybe should kids start getting the vaccine?
Well, I mean, it's currently approved from 12 years and up. So they're studying for younger age groups at this time. So at the moment, they're recommending anyone above 12 years of age to get the vaccine.
Mm-hmm. Is there any reason yet why maybe younger than that wouldn't get it, or we're not sure yet?
I think before they approve it for any age group, they do try to study that, right? So they are studying it in younger age groups, and once they have enough information on the safety efficacy, then they would go ahead with probably an emergency use authorization.
Mm-hmm. Given that that authorization hasn't been provided at this point, any concerns for maybe folks who are pregnant, you know, who have a baby that they're worried about?
Yeah, I mean, I think pregnancy, just like for influenza, COVID, you can have a more severe case. So certainly recommendations, wasn't approved for pregnancy, but it's certainly recommended to get it, because it's just that risk benefit.
Mm-hmm. In the medical community, what's the general outlook about COVID? Are we starting to get the upper hand? Do we feel like we're getting there?
Well, we thought we had the upper hand, guess, like a couple of weeks ago. So I think unless, you know, majority of the population is vaccinated or has caught COVID, you have to get this level of what they call herd immunity, right? You've heard that term.
Yeah.
But herd immunity is local. You can have at a national level, a high level of vaccination, but if you have pockets in the community or who you associate with that either have not had COVID or have not had the vaccine, you're at risk for getting COVID.
Mm-hmm. Do you think once the non-emergency approval comes through, the hesitancy will go away and more people will line up to get the vaccine?
I think probably for a certain percentage, but I don't know exactly, you know, who are thinking in that way.
Mm-hmm. There continues to be a lot of talk, Doctor, about booster shots. Does it sound like, do you think we're going to be having to have some booster shots in the future?
Well, I think they continuously reassess that. Prior to Delta, the thought was a healthy individual would not need a booster because at this point in time, it seemed to provide very good protection. I know they're discussing for people that have health conditions, immunocompromising health conditions or particular age that they may recommend boosters. The CDC is currently, you know, evaluating that.
Mm-hmm. One of the things that I hear from people who have had COVID is that they have a natural immunity. They don't need the vaccine. Are the vaccines more reliable or do they provide better protection than a natural immunity would give a person?
I mean, there's two points to that. In terms of, at this point, we do know that, you know, natural immunity, they've studied at least 6 to 8 months in terms of protection. I think the point is for the vaccination, the thought is that it boosts your immunity level, so maybe it reduces your chances of getting a second episode of COVID.
Many of us get annual flu shots. Could that also happen where we get an annual COVID shot?
It's to be determined. I know they're thinking about booster shots for sure, and it depends when this all thing settles out, what is the predominant strain out there? Is it going to continuously evolve?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Do you think that now that COVID has gone global, can we ever reach a zero point? Or is it just something where we're going to have to find an acceptable level of the virus and maybe even an acceptable level of deaths that we just have to live with?
I mean, I think at some point when it travels throughout the world, the population, you'll get this sort of this homeostasis balance where it still circulates, but it may not be as lethal or lower percentage of people get infected each year.
All right. Well, Dr. Prabhu, thank you so much for coming in and sharing some information. I'm sure we'll have you back again.
Yeah, thank you for inviting
me. Thank you very much.